对吧？行，今天我们势必要把这个 part two 的部分的残留的这些话题哈都讲到啊，这样的话我们，现有的题库都刷完了。第一个是电影，14，第十四个，王老师的故事啊，第十四个叫做 Describe a film you saw and you wanted to talk about with your friends，请你描述一部电影你看到过的，而且你想跟朋友分享一下这部电影。And you should say what film it was, what and where you watched this film, and what the film was about, and explain why you wanted to talk about or share this movie or this film with our friends. 这个话题还行吧，还行哈、啊，不算怪异，正常，正常啊，常态化。但是锁定哪部电影会小费点实力，所以今天呢，我给大家分享的一个电影呢，是我啊年轻时代看过的历史大片儿，是，哦，海报上来了，电影海报，看它的名字了吗？是这儿呢，看过这部电影没有？威尔史密斯和他儿子两个人联袂主演的，《当幸福来敲门》，听说过吗？好，看过吗？《当幸福来敲门》。人生励志戏，OK，主演是 Will Smith，你看这不上面写着吗？Will Smith，威尔史密斯，而且是奥斯卡提名奖嘞。然后这个是 The Pursuit of Happiness，幸福，追逐幸福的过程，英文名是这个。好，我们开始吧。Same as always, for a new story, we are going to read through the whole passage from the beginning to the end. All right. So the first paragraph，四秒。
Okay, let me talk about
听不到，听不到，你麦克风。
American movie。这个能听到吗？
听不到，你的麦克风不好使。
现在能听到吗？
那还需要调试啊，那我把机会给别人吧哈，
那
还需
我
要
怎
调
么听
试，
到
还需要
呢？
调试，那我就给博雅。在吗？关了个镜头，不在，在吗？我
在，
也听不到你说话呀。
老人听不到吗？
我能听到，不是，博雅，你能说话吗？我听不到你说
您
话
听不
哎。
到吗？
哟，是不是我这边有问题呀？你说话我都听不到啊。小魏，你说话我听听。
听得到吗？
坏了坏了，那是我的问题。这怎么调啊？麦克风。喂喂喂喂喂，扬声器。喂喂喂喂喂喂喂，我得重新进一把，同学们，我这没有声音。我重新进一下啊。喂喂，听到吗，同学们？小魏同学，听得到我说话吗？
可以，我可以听
好的，那我们一起来过一下第三章、第二章，看看这个《幸福来敲门》讲了什么故事。Here we go。
Okay, let me talk about an American movie called The Pursuit of Happiness, which is adopted from the real experience of a legendary financier in the United States of America, which name is Chris Gardner. The first time that I saw this movie was in an English class in my senior high school. Our English teacher played the film for us, because he wanted to motivate us to fight hard for our dreams.
OK, thank you. 好，继续宋茜，
可以听到吗？
可以听到。
The film tell us a self motivation motivational story, which happens at San Francisco.
旧金山 San Francisco.
San Francisco in U.S. The leading role is named Chris, who suffered a lot from his tough life. For example, his wife left him and his little son due to his unstable income. What's worse, Chris even doesn't have enough money to pay the tuition for his little son and the rent to his landlord. Regardless of the miserable life, Chris never gives up his pursuit on his dream. After going through ups and downs in his life, the happiness that belongs to his arrives finally.
Mm-hmm. Okay. 好，诗雅，最后一段。
The reason why I would like to share this movie with my friend is that most of my friends are struggling hard with their work or study. I mean that they are suffering a lot of depression, anxiety, and some other mental pressures. I hope that spirit from the leading role in this movie can inspire my friends to keep an active and optimistic attitude towards their life.
Okay, thank you. 好吧，让我谈一谈一部美国电影吧。American movie， 电影的名字叫《追逐幸福》，叫《当幸福来敲门》。Which is adapted from 的取材于改编自 ，OK， 改编自一个什么一个真正的人生经历，谁的呢 ？A legendary financier， 一个传奇般的金融家。金融专家在美国的一个传奇般的金融行业的人物，你听说过巴菲特吗？股神巴菲特，他是个白人，听说过吗？股神巴菲特，他是个白人，是个美国人，是吧？他在黑人圈里面有一个跟巴菲特齐名的一个玩股炒股啊，什么玩弄资本市场的一个男士，叫 Chris Gardner， 真人真事啊，克里斯加德内 ，All right， whose name is Chris Gardner。那个人火了以后呢，居然有人给他写自传哈，访谈以后写了一本人物自传，然后给这本书卖的很火。后来呢，导演很聪明，就给拿来拍了片儿，听吗？这都是真实情况啊。啊，王老师之前做过一些了解和调研。其实我们年轻人看电影就是看电影了呗 ，just for fun。但有些时候呢，对吧？有深度的片子，我们还需要去深究一下，是不是？绿皮书，对不对？还有什么贫民窟的百万富翁？对不对？那些电影都是有可以往后倒一倒历史背景的。All right， 我第一次看这个电影的时候是在高中的英语课堂里面 ，English class in the high school。我们班老师，我们英语老师给我们播放这部电影，就是为了，因为他想要激励我们 ，motivate， 激励我们去为了梦想而奋斗。激励这个词儿叫 motivate，to motivate us， 干嘛呢 ？Fight hard for our dreams， 为了梦想而奋斗 ，fight， 打架，奋斗。这部电影给我们讲了一个什么故事 ？Self-motivational， 励志的故事，自我激励的故事。Self-motivational story，a self-motivational story， 给我们讲了励志性的故事，发生在美国旧金山 （San Francisco）。主角 leading role， 这电影的主角呢，名叫 Chris， 叫克里斯，马上就是尊重原什么呀？本这个人物的真身呢，人家真身叫 Chris Gardner， 他遭受了很多的什么？He suffered a lot from his tough life. 人生艰难的人生当中，让他什么很痛苦。比方说他有多痛苦呢？他的妻子离开了他和他的儿子，由于他不稳定的收入。OK， 如果看过同学应该知道 ，Chris 一开始是个销售员，卖那个医疗设备，叫骨密度测试仪，但自己呢牙不尖嘴不利，工作也不勤奋 ，OK， 心也不在了上面，所以挣不到钱，家里非常的不稳定，妻子离开他了，甚至呢。 Chris even doesn't have enough money, 甚至没有足够的钱儿去给他的儿子来付学费。To pay the tuition, to pay the tuition, 付学费给他的小儿子。也没有钱去给 landlord, 房东来付房租。OK, 这是生活 的窘迫的细节。Regardless of the miserable life, 这是一个 OK, 让步状语。叫做尽管生活如此艰辛，如此的 miserable, 痛苦。Regardless of, 尽管无论 okay, 无论生活多么艰辛 ,Chris, 从来没有放弃过对梦想的追逐。在经历了很多的 ups and downs, 起起落落坎坎坷坷之后，他的幸福属于他的那份幸福就来临了。The happiness that belongs to himself, belongs to, 属于归属，属于他自个儿那份幸福就来临了。我为什么想要把这部电影分享给我的朋友呢？是因为我多数的朋友们正在 struggling,hard, 那努力奋斗为了他们的学业和工作，为了人生打拼吧。我多数的朋友都在什么呀，为了学习和工作而努力打拼。我的意思是他们遭受了很多什么，他们遭受了很多的压抑，很多的焦躁，还有其他的一些精神压力。我希望这个 the spirit from the leading role, 回答主角的这股精神吧，这个电影主角的这股精神能够去 inspire, 鼓舞到我的朋友们，能够让他们去 keep an active and optimistic attitude towards their life, 能够保持一个积极的乐观的态度去面对他们的人生。 OK, 这就是我们今早上第一个范文哈。这个作文我写了好多年了，你知道吗？还不是写了有三五年了。 OK, 因为这个片子对我的印象特别深刻，但很有电影的雅思口语话题，我都会把这个故事翻出来跟大家分享一下。行，那我们像往常一样把这个文章蚕食掉吧。我希望能够在50个单词以内吧，30到50个单词这样的一个分量之内把这个文章给捋出来啊。Okay, let me talk about an American movie called The Pursuit of Happiness. 这个电影名字得背啊，名字都得背啊。The Pursuit of Happiness.这个它是什么？它是采编语，改编字怎么说？改编字取材于 adapted from the real life experience, 真正的人生经历。谁的呢？一个传奇般的金融专家 legendary financier 金融客金融家，在美国 US。名字叫 Chris, 哎，这哥们儿有名人家啊，真人人就是叫 Chris 加的内 ，Chris, 怎么写 Chris Gardner, 好，第二站段，我第一次看这个电影的时候是我的高中英语课堂 ，in the English class in my high school。In an English class, okay, in the senior high, 高中的时候的英语课堂，我们班英语老师 ，our English teacher played the movie for us. 老师给我们播放了 ，okay, 他播放这个片子的目的是干嘛 ？To motivate, 鼓舞我们大家 ，to motivate us, 干嘛去？去为了梦想而奋斗吧 ，fight hard.奋斗打拼拼搏这个词就 fight hard for our dreams, for our dreams, 为了梦想而奋斗。这个电影给我们讲了一个什么故事？励志性的故事，会这词会吗？ This film tells us a self-motivational story, 发生在 San Francisco, 三藩市 SF 市。主角呢？The leading role named Chris, 主角叫 leading role, 他怎么了？他遭受了人生的苦难是吧？ He suffered a lot from his painful life, from his tough life, 艰难的人生。比方说 for example, 他的妻子离开他， his wife left him, 妻离子散嘛 his wife left him,and his little son, And due to 因为什么？因为他收入不稳定呗，这哥们卖不出去东西啊。Unstable income, unstable, unstable income。还有多糟糕 ？What's worse？ 更糟糕的是 What's worse？ 更糟糕的是他没有足够的钱去 to pay right to pay the tuition。For his little son, 也没有钱去付给谁，去付那个 rent 房租 to his landlord， 没有钱给房东付房租。尽管生活如此艰辛，这句话不好背啊。Regardless， 虽然尽管 regardless of his painful life, miserable life， 尽管生活如痛苦，但是 Chris never gives up。Chris never legendary 原来没有放弃对自己梦想的追逐。最后呢 ，after going through， 在经历了很多很多的艰难坎坷之后 ，after going through lots of ups and downs， 起起落落 ，up and down， 他的幸福就来临了。His happiness finally arrived in the end. 我为什么想把这部电影分享给朋友呢？是因为很多我的朋友 ，most of my friends are struggling， 正在奋斗，为了人生而奋斗 ，struggling hard for their what? For their work or study， 工作或学业。下一句呢？他们遭受了很多的我希望什么 ？I hope the spirit， 主角的这股精神。Spirit from the leading role， 能够去鼓舞到我的朋友们 ，inspire my friends， 让他们保持一个乐观和积极的态度面对人生的挑战 ，to keep 保持一个积极的叫 active and 乐观的 optimistic attitude towards their life。好吧，孩子们，电影影评送给你们，电影影评，一分钟时间呗，一两分钟时间看看原文啊，跟往常一样练口语啊，开始。Hey guys, you have 2 minutes to look, read through the whole passage again, and then you are supposed to give your speech based on these keywords right here.
Tuition. Landlord.
All right, time's up. 思淼同学，给我说一个演讲吧，谈论一部电影。
Okay, let me talk about
talk about an American movie called the Pursuit of Happiness, which is adapted from the Rolling Stones. For parents, our legendary financier in the U.S. stated, whose name is Chris Gardner. The first time that I watched the film is in an English class in the senior high school. Our English teacher played this movie to motivate us to fight hard for our dream. The film tells us a self-motivational story at SF in the United States. The leading role is
名叫克里斯, it's named Chris.
The leading role is named Chris, who suffered a lot from his tough life. And his wife, his wife left him due to his unstable income. What's worse, Chris even didn't have enough money to pay the tuition for his son and rent to his landlord. Regardless of his miserable life, Chris never gave up his dream. After going through lots of ups and downs, his happiness arrived finally. And the reason why I'd like to share this movie to my friends is that my friends are struggling hard for their work or study.
我希望这个主角的精神头。I
hope their spirit from their leading can inspire my friends to keep an active and optimistic attitude for their life.
Okay, thank you. Well done. 真棒。语速可以再加快一点啊，他故事捋得非常棒啊。OK, 帅帅的。好，再来一个机会。是呀 ,one more time. Talk about a film you watched before and you would like to talk about it or share the movie with your friends. Here we go.
The movie I want to talk about is The Pursuit of Happiness, which is adapted from a legendary financiers in the United States, whose name is Chris Gardner. I see this movie in my high school, which my English teacher played it to us. And she hoped to motivate us to fight hard for our dreams. It's a self-motivational story in the San Francisco. And the leading role is
named Chris.
Who is suffering from a lot from his tough life, because his wife left him and his sons for his unstable income. What worse, he even not have enough money to pay the tuition for his sons and the rent to his landlord. Regardless of his miserable life, Chris never gave up his dream. After going through lots of ups and downs, Chris finally Chris' happiness finally arrived. I want to share this with my friends because they are all struggling hard for their work and study. So I hope the spirit from the leading role can inspire my friend to keep them active and optimistic attitude for their life.
Towards their life, 面对人生 towards. Okay, well done, well done, well done. 刘佳，我说的范儿有了啊，内容非常的详实。你看过这电影吗？是呀。哇，你关麦的速度好神奇啊，唰就没人了。
知道。
啊，你看过这个电影是吗？啊 ，OK OK。今天晚上闲来无事的话，可以看看这个老片子啊，还不得有20年了之久了。好的，就这样吧。今天上午的第一个话题我们就先放到这里啊。没有机会练同学呢，要把这个截屏，把这个关键词截屏，自己去练一下。OK， 如果你愿意的话，就包括给我发录音，对吧？让我再看看你是否 OK 讲的够不够流畅，有没有一些明显的发音错误 ？All right。好，我们来接触今天上午的第二个故事，叫做《坐着火车去西藏》，好美的风光啊！好多班同学都说好喜欢这张图啊。OK， 一个破绿皮车，对吧？载着一行游客去往大山深处。有过这样人生经历吗？坐没坐过绿皮车？坐着火车去外地玩，有过这样的经历吗？小薇？
有。
有。宗倩呢？没有，要么是自驾，要么坐飞机，是不是？
不是，我在那个Interlaken 坐过那个黄金列车。
黄金列车是啥意思啊？
就是，它那个叫 Golden Tree， 然后但它不是，
黄色的。
不是，它那个车很好看，但是它不是一个绿皮车，它就是在中穿梭，然后带你看他那方属于一个观光的火车。
好的。好，我看这道题哈，再考啊，再考。题库当中非常火爆的题叫 Describe a trip you had by taking public transportation， 请你描述一次旅行，你乘坐公共交通工具进行的一次旅行，乘坐公共交通进行的一次旅行。这年头能去旅行，跟旅行的沾上边的公共交通工具也就是两样呗。OK， 一个就是 train， 一个是 airplane， 然后还有一个是那 cruise 游轮，是吧 ？Ocean liner。OK， 就三样，这道题没有什么别的选材，你不能说了，说我开的我们家私家车呀，哎，抱歉，那玩意儿不叫 public transportation， 公共交通。OK， 老师，我骑着共享单车呀，请你给我骑共享单车，我去广东试试。OK， 不得把你给累趴下呀。So you should say when and where you had a trip. 你什么时候去哪儿玩了 ？And what kind of transportation you took? 你坐什么交通工具了 ？Why you took this kind of transportation? 你为什么要坐这种交通工具 ？And explain how you felt about this trip. 你对这次旅行感受如何？好的，我就让大家尽量回忆一下你们自己是否有过的人生经历啊。如果有的话，很好；如果没有的话，正好跟我神游啊，神游一下我去南方的一次故事。All right. Let me choose someone to read it, the story. Boya.
Last summer vacation, I planned to have a tour to Shanghai. I took the bullet train.
Bullet train, 子弹头列车。和谐号。
Bullet train. Bullet train. Although taking the train is slower than taking the airplane, I didn't care about it because as a student, I had much time during the vacation. More importantly, in The train ticket is 1/3 cheaper than the flight ticket as a northerner. In my country, I seldom travel to the south part of China. I know the train would pass by 5 major provinces provinces in south part. I was looking forward to seeing different signs. 风景怎么说来着？
风景景色 scenery
对 scenery is the in the different parts of the country.
Okay, thank you. 那梦竹 continue， 下一站段是你的。
Other talking, the train is slower than
the moment when I
stamp on this train, my wonderful January had already gone started. Because the train passed by 5 provinces and hundreds of lovely cities and towers. I appreciate different views.
Views, 景色景观 views.
Different views through the train window. For example, when the train moved on the plain of northeast China, I saw many
majestic.
I saw many majestic mountains and bushy forest. And when the train moved to the south part of China, like Hubei province and Jiangsu province, I saw some different landscape and architectures. All those things made my trip even more amazing. I saved much money from taking the train to Shanghai rather than airplanes. So I did many more interesting things by using the money.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. 好，我们把这篇文章给它捋出来啊，捋出来以后你们演讲。嗯，我估计你们应该蛮习惯和蛮喜欢王老师这种教学方法的。故事给你放这儿，词儿给你，但自己当时说一遍，对不对？去年暑假 ，last summer vacation， 我计划的去 ，I planned to have a tour to Shanghai。时间是 last summer vacation。A 地点是上海，或里面有个词叫去上海旅游，叫 take a tour 观光去上海。然后呢，我最终选择的是 bullet train， 这词认识吗？子弹头列车，高速铁路，高铁叫 high speed railway。咱们中国的和谐号叫 bullet train，bullet train 也叫 high speed railway。 下一句呢，你为什么要坐火车呀？人刚刚提语问你了， what means of transportation you took to Shanghai。 我告诉你了， I took the train, but why you chose to take the train but not airplane? Because of two reasons. Although taking the train slower than 虽然坐火车慢于什么 slower than taking the airplane， 但是我并不在意。 But I didn't care about it. Not care about it， 不在乎，无所谓。为啥？因为作为一个学生， because as a student I had much more time enough time during the vacations， 作为一个学生，穷的就剩时间了，是吧？ As a student, I had enough time during the vacation. More importantly, 更重要的是 more importantly, 省钱啊。The train ticket, the train ticket is one third. 分子读成 OK 序数词，不对，基数词，一二三四五，分母读成序数词，第一、第二、第三、第四、第五，这是分数读法，大家听吗？三分之一叫做 one third, one third cheaper than what? Cheaper 便宜什么？火车票要比机票便宜三分之一嘞，对吧？况且最重要的原因是因为作为一个北方人 ，as a northerner， 作为一个北方人 ，northerner， 我之前也没怎么去南方玩过 ，I seldom travel to the south of China， I seldom 很少，几乎不。I seldom travel to the south of China. And 我知道这辆火车会 pass by 途经路过五个主要省份 ，five major provinces. Provinces 什么什么湖北啊，江苏啊，什么什么玩意儿。嗯，然后在南方地区，我特别期待看到不一样的景色。嗯哼 ，I was looking forward to. I was looking forward 期待的 ，looking forward.Forward to seeing 看到不一样的风光 different landscapes, different sceneries in different parts of the country. Right? Seeing different sceneries 不一样的风光景色叫什么 sceneries in different parts. The moment 当我踏上火车那一刻 the moment when I stepped on the train.On the train, 我的精彩旅行就开始了。My wonderful journey got started. My wonderful journey, 精彩的旅途 journey got started 就开始了。Get started 就启程了。因为火车路过五个省份，上百个村镇，是吧 ？You know the train passed by. The train passed by what? Passed by five provinces and hundreds of what? Hundreds of 上百个。Hundreds of cities and towns, 城镇 cities and towns. 我欣赏了不同的风景在车窗以外 I appreciated it. I watched, I saw different views through the train window. 通过车窗 through the train window, the train windows, the train window. 比方说我看到什么了？比方说当火车在东北平原行驶的时候 ，when the train moved on the 华北什么东北东北没有平原 ，moved on the plain of northern China, right? Northern China 华北平原 Northern China 的时候，我看到了什么？不是平原，怎么还有山脉呢？我这逻辑有问题啊 ！When the train moved in, when the train moved in the northeastern China, I saw 群山峻岭，浓密的森林，那俩词很讨厌。我看到了群山峻岭那个词认识吗 ？Majestic mountains, 宏伟的山脉。Majestic mountains, 宏伟的山脉和什么？和浓密的森林，茂密的森林叫 bushy, 茂密的浓密的 bushy forests.当火车开到南方以后呢 ？When the train moved to the south of China， 华南地区呢？比方说湖南、湖北啊，对吧？景色就完全不一样。I saw some different landscapes and architectures. I saw some different 不一样的什么风貌，不是地形地貌 ，landscapes and architectures. Architectures.我省了很多钱 ，I saved much money. 我省下很多钱，坐火车去上海。I saved money, much money. 省了很多钱，所以我最后做出了没有 ？So I did many interesting things by using the money in Shanghai. OK， 比方说你有两千块旅游资金，如果你坐飞机过去的话，可能会花1000块钱，你只有1000块钱在那边住店吃饭了。可是我坐火车过去呢，只花了170块钱， 哇，我有两千，我有1830块钱可以让自己玩耍，懂了吗？对吧？路途辛苦一点，当地玩的还玩的好一点，就这样吧，孩子们，这故事没有那么难了。All right， 2分钟时间再看一眼吧，故事情节再了解一下，演讲待会儿。Right, thumbs up. Now, Fangzi, talk about your travel experience of taking the public transportation, I mean the train, to somewhere. Here we go.
Last summer vacation, I have a tour to Shanghai. I take a bullet train. Although taking the train is slower than taking a flight,But I really not care about this because as a student, I had adequate time during my vacation. More importantly, the train ticket is 1/3 cheaper than flight ticket. As a northerner, I seldom travel to south part of China. I knew this train would pass by 5 major provinces. I was looking forward to seeing different sceneries in different parts of China. When I stepped on this train, my wonderful journey got started. This train passed by 5 provinces and hundreds of cities and towns. I appreciate the wonderful views to the train window. For example, when the train moved on, I saw the majestic mountains and bushy forests.
In the northeastern part of China.
To the south of China. When the train traveled to the south part of China,like Jiangsu province and Zhejiang province, I saw different landscapes and different styles of architectures, which it made my journey even more exciting. And what's more, I also saved much money because I taking the bullet train. So I use this saved money to other events. Can I take this turn?
All right. Good try. Nice job. 小魏同学, once again, talk about a trip you took by taking the public transportation. Here we go.
When last summer vacation, I planned to have a tour to Shanghai. I took the bullet train. Even also taking the train is slower than taking the airplane. I don't care about it. Because as a student, I have much time during my vacation. More importantly, the train ticket is one third cheaper than flight ticket. As a northerner in my country, I seldom travel to the south part. I know the train would pass by five major provinces in the south part. I was looking forward to see different sceneries in different parts of China. When I stepped on the train, the wonderful journey had already got started. The train passed by five provinces and hundreds of cities and towns. I saw them through the train window. For example, in the northeastern of China, I saw majestic mountains and bushy forests. And when the train moved to the south of China, I saw different landscapes and architectures from north of China. Because I take the train, I save much money to play in my dynasty.
Destination. Well done. All right. Well done. Good job. 行，就这样吧。 刚才我们讲的是第二个，坐的火车去上海，甭管去哪儿吧，不一定非得上海，随便改看一听不就完了？去云南，去昆明 ，whatever， 去广西 ，right， whatever it is。我们需要讲的就是火车绿皮车的故事，绿皮车的故事，在听吗？绿皮车的故事。All right， 一个慢车，慢慢悠悠的行驶在中华大地上面，但是我并不在乎，因为我穷的就剩时间了。OK， 我更宁愿把这个旅游经费哈花在当地的美食啊。 美景上面，而不愿意花在坐火车交通工具上面，你懂我的意思吗？对吧？人生经历此一时彼一时的。也许你们怎么样？以后上了班了，对吧？经济基础强大了，就想的是那，对吧？这个时间就是金钱啊，早点到了，早点玩啊，对吧？那是有钱人的想法。没钱的人想的是，我还是把钱花在刀刃上吧 ，right？ Spend the right money on right thing. You know what I mean? Because as a student, you don't have enough money. Okay? You don't have too much money. Okay, maybe you just got 2,000 RMB, right? 2,000 yuan from your parents. Okay, you didn't want to spend too much money on the, I don't know, on the transportation. Right? So finally, you chose the most economical, 经济实惠的, the most economical way to travel to the south of China, right? That is train. I mean, the bullet train. Okay, but it was still a wonderful journey because when the train moved, okay, through the whole country, right, not the whole country, when the train moved, right, on the way, you saw different sceneries, okay, different architectures, or okay, maybe when the train stopped at one station, you could buy some local snacks, local food, right, from the vendors on the platform, 听懂了吗？在站台上的一些小贩儿卖给你一些当地的特产，有过这样的经历吗？孩子们，下车能够停5分钟时间，有过这样的经历吗？至少，就是慢车，可以来到一个城市之后，然后那个车可能去维修一下，或者是检修什么玩意儿的，可能会停留10分钟、20分钟的样子。好多成年人下去抽烟 ，OK， 好多人上车的时候还会买一些当地特产，有过这样的经历吗？
电视上看过。
电视上看过，我经历过，那可能是你们年龄小啊，你不怎么外出啊。OK， 挺爽的，火车一路走到哪儿就买到当地的什么，去了山东买烧鸡翅，买什么德州扒鸡，到了沈阳 OK 买点什么当地的什么什么香肠腊肠，还听吗 ？OK， yeah， 就这样吧。我们准备接触今天上午的另外一个故事，好难的，好难的，没有范文，所以没有探讨。Describe a change that can improve your local area， 什么意思？标题问的。请描述一个改变，这一改变会提升，会提升你们当地的市容市貌或当地的居住环境。第一道题，第二个 ，describe an article you read from the internet about healthy lifestyle。请你描述一篇文章，你什么？你在网上读过的一篇文章，这文章是关于健康生活方式的。咱先别考虑合并了。你先读单独想一想这两个话题都说什么好吧。Describe a change that can improve your local area， 就是说你认为你的 local area 约等于什么？在雅思里面的 local area 约等于 your city your hometown， 在听吗？雅思里面考试很怪啊，它用词有点小偏颇，有点小个性。这里面的Your local area， 你们当地 ，OK， 就等于 ，OK， 我们经常中国人喜欢说的什么 ，Your hometown，Your city， 你觉得你的家乡或你的城市需要哪个 change， 需要怎样的一个 change， 然后这个 change 会怎么改变你们当地啊 ？What change it should be？How this change could be made？And why the change can improve your local area？ 好，陈一龙。你觉得你的城市，你的 local area， 你的 city， 你的 hometown 需要怎样的 change？
Well, I think there are many problems in my city, because I think there are many air pollution and also traffic congestions in my city. So I think the government should enhance the nature environment or the transportation speed. In this way, I think we can enjoy a better life. That's it.
是你没说清楚，还是我们没有 get 到的点啊？那到底你们家乡需要什么样的一个改，哪一个改变啊？到底是空气质量还是交通设施啊？
Both of these。
还是交通状况啊？
I think
两者都需要。
Yes.
No. A change. Describe one change that can improve your local area. A means one.Only one. You have to decide one.
Public transportation should be improved.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, you are right. You are not wrong. But I think Beijing as the capital of China, it has already built.Okay, very good public transportation system. For example, we have more than 20 subway lines, okay, connecting different parts of the city. How the transportation could be improved, could be changed to improve your local area. Have you feel so worried about this kind of decision? 你这个抉择让我感觉有点担心哈。你要说有改变，这一改变会改进你们当地的居住环境总体状态，在讨论你们见到的今天上午这两个话题，我画蓝框，这两个是当季题库啊，一到四月份题库当中最难的两道题，但它依然在考中。OK， a change that can improve your local area。
Well, I think maybe the government should add more sport facilities to the public.
Mm-hmm.
Such as.
哦，好可惜啊！这小伙还继续说，我看到我怎么把他请上台来啊？他说的是我想听到的方向。等等啊，这个举手了以后怎么把他叫上来呢？好，上来了，继续啊，继续。你说实话，北京的公共健身设施多吗 ？Tell me the truth, young man. As a Beijinger, as a Beijing local resident here in Beijing.Do you think the city can provide us a lot of sports, public sports facilities? I don't think so. Okay, there are no more than 10. There are no more than 5 big stadiums or gymnasiums for local people to use. Okay? 首钢体育馆、工体、首体没了。再安装体育馆，就北京的公共健身设施并不是特别多。事实是这样的，所以说我需要。我们的加上那个一个改变 ，one change， the one change that I really want to see in my local area is that we should have what? There should be more sports centers, 体育中心 sports centers or stadiums for citizens to use, right? 嗯，我们捋出来一个小细节，就是要多建一些什么？一个改变之一就是什么呀 ？To build， 去建造是吧 ？Build more.Sports centers, 运动中心体育中心 sports centers, or you can say stadium, 或者多建一些什么运动设施吧 To build more public sports facilities, right? Public sports facilities. 比方说刚才王老师说的那个什么 sports centers, 体育中心呢 stadiums, 体育馆啊之类的啊 ，So Elon, continue.
The reason why I think more sports center or sports facilities should be provided to the public is that because I think people are very busy in modern life.But they become unhealthy because of lack of sport
or
exercise. So if there are many sports facilities in the local community.They maybe want to try have a try after they work. So, in this way, they can improve their quality of life and also enjoy the good fit.Health feed.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's very, very
necessary to have necessary. More public sports to have such a change.
Yeah.
How this change could be made?
Firstly, I think the public should provide more money and.And support to the local community to help them to build the system of sports facility, and also build some buildings such as the sports center or stadiums in the center of city. So it will be very convenient for people to access there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well done. 非常棒啊，非常棒，继续演讲，给你大大点个赞啊。我在备课的时候也想的是我们的城市需要的一个明显的改变哈，一个必须要的提升，一个 improvement， 一个必要的一个 change， 就是要去多建一些运动设施啊，因为现如今我们生活压力大了嘛，就像伊隆说的一样。 Okay, nowadays modern people are very busy with their work or study, right? They are under much pressure. Okay. So, I still have some information to share with you, my friend. Check this out. With the improvement of people's lifestyle, with the improvement of people's lifestyle and the consciousness of keeping a healthy lifestyle, the existing public sports facilities in our local area are not able to meet people's demands. So,It is advisable for our government, local government, to invest more budget on finance, establishing more sports facilities. With the rapid development of information technology, the number of farmers and the homebodies increase a lot. Apparently, the dangers of this kind of sedentary lifestyle are quite frightening. So people of today are suggested to drop their phones and walk out of their house to do more physical exercises, like running, which is one of the most natural forms of exercise. 到这儿吧，到这儿，应该我分享的东西可以结束了，因为我写了一小段嘛，一小段，就是我们为什么需要多建一些体育设施，是因为什么？人们生活水平提升了，
熟练都行。
还有呢，保持健康生活方式的这种 consciousness 意识增强了，在听吗？随着人们生活水平提升，也随着人们对于健康生活方式什么呀，保健这种意识增强 ，consciousness 意识什么意识？保持健康的意识增强。The current 现在的目前的或者 existing 现存的一些什么既有的一些公共设施是没法满足我们的需求了 ，are not able to meet 满足人们的需求了 ，meet people's demands 又是一个
community，OK，、
okay? 满足人们的需求就 meet people's demands， 所以建议我们什么 ？It is advisable， 非常建议我们当地政府去投入更多的资金，投入资金叫 invest some finance or budget， 去建立更多的运动设施 ，establishing。More sports facilities. 好，这是第一个原因，为什么我们需要多建体育设施？第二个呢 ？With the rapid development of information technology, 随着信息技术产业的发展，大量的 farmers， 认识吗？这词儿 ，farmers， 低头族，玩手机的人，低头族叫 farmers， 爱玩手机的人叫 farmers。Fathers and homebodies 认识吗 ？Homebodies 宅男宅女宅人 ，OK， 大量增加。随着科技的发展，宅男和什么和低头族的数量也不断增加。很显然呢 ，apparently 这种危害 ，the dangers of this kind of sedentary lifestyle 久坐不站立的久坐的生活方式的危害是非常吓人的。所以建议当代人什么？建议当代人要去 drop their phones， 放下手机 ，drop their phones and walk out of their house， 走出户外，走出家门以外，去多做一些 physical exercises， 比方说跑步啊、打球啊之类的。OK， 这些细节特别想写作是吧？很严肃，所以我也不想让大家说一定要背起来，但是你们要跟我学几个词嘛，对吧？往里把它安插在刚才伊隆的演讲当中，就是说你的城市需要怎样的改变呢？Well, the one change that my city really needs, right? The one improvement that my hometown or local area really needs is about the sports facilities. 为啥呀？那是因为随着人们生活水平的提升， 对和对于健康生活方式理念的提升，意识提升，现如今的公共健身设施根本没法满足人们的需求了。大家听吗？我刚才举的例子不是拿北京举例子吗？对吧？北京不有那么几个体育馆吗？哪够这2200万人的去玩耍的呀？通常是体育馆根本就怎么讲，没有席位啊，篮球场没有位置，足球场人们没换啊。那这个改变如何实现呢 ？How the change could be made? How the change could be made? 如何实现呢？我觉得政府嘛，政府应当是多投入一些资金。It is advisable. 建议我们政府。It is advisable for our government to invest some finance. 投入一些资金，建立更多的 sports facilities， 一些运动设施。我们为什么需要这样的改变呢？那是因为这个我们久坐的生活方式是吧？信息技术的，就是那个科技的发展，低头族的数量增加了。很显然 ，OK， 这种久坐不站立的生活方式一定会给我们带来非常的很多的危害，很多的 dangers， 很多的 hazards。OK， 所以建议当代人应该放下手机，走到户外去多锻炼锻炼。All right。也没有范文啊，没有范文，顶多要说有的话，顶多有100来个字的王老师这段文字的一个 support， 看来你们自己要去想很多的干货了。是刚才一龙说的不错啊 ，describe a change which can improve your local area。来，现在跟老师来可以聊一下下一道题啊，描述一个在网上读过的一篇文章，这文章是关于健康生活方式的，所以你要告诉我的是你什么时候。这篇文章什么时候在哪儿刊登的 ？Posted 叫发布的。这文章是何时在哪儿发布的？这文章讲了什么内容 ？OK， 你对于这个文章感受如何？我问大家有没有这样人生经历啊？有没有在网上看过任何关于 healthy lifestyle 健康生活方式的那种推文啊？那种软文啊，鸡汤啊 ，chicken soup 呀、啊？什么一天一个鸡蛋，不是一天一个苹果，一生远离我呀？什么食生相克？就哪种食物不能跟那个植物吃啊 ？OK， 什么冬天不能露脚脖子呀？就是你们家里面有没有家庭群？幸福家庭群？你发现群里面你的大舅妈和你外婆经常给你转的文章就是那样的文章吗 ？Healthy lifestyle。Healthy lifestyle， 讨论一下吧。没有范文啊，不用等着我了。我就说这道题很难的，我们要即兴创作一下。啊，什么时候在哪儿发布的？这个倒简单啊。Where 这可以编的吗？什么时候在哪儿看的 ？When and where you saw this article？ Sorry， you saw or you read this article？ 你什么时候在哪儿？要自己编一下 article， 然后下一位问的是，这文章讲了什么 ？What the article was about？ The article was about。那我们就来探讨一下，同学们，你们读过这类型的文章，它讲了什么方面？哪个方面需要健？什么是健康的生活方式的代表？细节之一，小薇，在你读过的这类型的文章当中。他给你推广什么方案了？
推广什么方案？什么早睡早起
？Yeah, that's right. That's right. 这俩事儿吧？你说是俩事儿？你说是两件事儿？第一个是 early to bed, early to rise, 早睡早起 ，early to rise, 早睡早起。其实这个按照标准。按照什么学术英语不是写作式英语来写的话，就是保持一个规律作息时间，对不对？保持一个规律作息时间 ，to keep a regular, right? Regular 规律的 life schedule 作息时间 ，life schedule。OK， 刚才小魏还说了一个什么，多做什么，锻炼身体是吧？嗯 ，do more exercise， 嗯。好，再讨论。 那梦竹告诉我，你读过这类型的文章吗？什么 healthy lifestyle 健康生活方式的文章，鸡汤？
好像很少。
嗯哼，那你看这篇文章如果考到大家的话，是不是发现英语只是一回事儿，中文编造也是一回，也中文的储备也是一回事儿，是不是？那你想一想吧，什么是健康生活方式？刚才小魏说是早睡早起，另外多锻炼，那你怎么认为？
嗯，就是正常的作息时间，保持健康的作息。然后，还有饮食健康。
嗯 ，very good， healthy diet， 健康的饮食，健康的饮食 ，good job。博雅呢？你读过的这类型的软文吗？
很少吧，我们一般都去辟谣。
就你们这个年龄段的特点是 no do no die 是吧？越告诉你这玩意儿能够，这玩意儿吃了有毒啊？是吗？试试呗，香蕉蘸白糖，对吧？三秒钟暴毙，是吗？哥们儿不信，买了一筐香蕉，买了一堆白糖，蘸完了以后发现没毛病啊，没事儿啊。OK， 我给你出一方案啊，你可以吃一颗香蕉，然后再喝一瓶可乐，你看看效果如何？巨明显。一颗香蕉。
比如说，喝茶要什么比喝饮料好啊，然后对身体有好处啊，什么什么的。
那个也是饮食吧，健康饮食 ，healthy diet 饮食嘛，只不过什么呀，发展的方向就是，
养生，
细节就是养生，养生，那不就是 health care 吗？
健康是为了活着，养生是为了活得更长。这是两个概念，老师。你保持健康是为了你能继续活下去，然后养生是为了你活得更长。
同意，说的有道理。Healthcare 养生这事儿怎么了？能够让你去活得更健康、更快乐、更长是吗？
对啊。
To prolong, to expand, to expand, 延长我们的生命周期 to expand our life expectancy, 延长我们的生命周期叫 to expand our life expectancy, expectancy. Good. 我觉得这一个点我们够了哈，我们就为了某一个点再写成二十个字的话，这篇文章，就我读的这篇推送，这篇软文一共对吧？一共分为三个段段，第一段段讲的是生活规律要作息，第二段段讲的是要健康参加体育锻炼，第三个段段讲的是健康餐饮，在听吗？没有。关于你什么时候看的，在哪儿看的，这真的无所谓吧？真心无所谓吧？什么坐地铁不看的？昨天晚上我外婆发给我的，这都无所谓的，你知道吗 ？Right？ 好像北京人在大城市里面坐地铁特无聊，什么百无聊赖，各种刷手机，你发现没有？最近坐过地铁吗？一排腿，然后呢一排手机都是一个型号的，对吧？一溜 iPhone， 一排大腿都是这样，然后。Next station， 惠新西街 station， 让一下下车，对不对？造型都一模一样哈。那个，所以就编成什么？上礼拜嘛，我坐的地铁回去上学的路上或者回家路上很无聊，在玩手机打发时间，就在一个什么，在一个社交网站，在一个网站上面，微博上面，你可以给我推送了什么 ？OK， I saw a notification from Weibo on my cell phone. Hey, 我看到了一条推送。I saw a notification, 推送 notification, okay, from the Weibo, right? Microblog on my cell phone, 在我的手机上面。微信给我推送了微博给我推送了一个文章。正好我也没什么事嘛。 正好我这次地铁，我这坐小火车我得坐上什么呀 almost 30 minutes, right? Or 45 minutes, 45分钟很无聊。所以我就干嘛，我就点开了这篇文章是吧，我就点开了这篇文章，他说我就点进了手机，点了一下屏幕，然后呢这个页面展开了，怎么说，
嗯，
点击叫什么 ?I touched, 点击那个词叫 click. Yeah, I clicked, 点击敲击 I clicked on my cell phone screen, right? On my, 我的手机屏幕 my cell phone screen, and, okay, 一篇长长的文章吧 a long passage was presented in front of my eyes, a long passage, 一篇长长的什么 passage, okay, 短文文章叫 passage, 或者叫 article, 在听吗，一篇长文就展现在 was presented, 呈现在 presented, in front of my eyes, 这文章主要讲了两大维度吧，两大维度的健康。This what the article was about, 首先这个文章给我讲了一下什么，就保持规律的作息的必要性是吧。 Firstly, firstly, this article, right? 这个文章给我讲了什么？ This article, 讲述了保持规律作息的必要性。他说。
It is extremely
highlights, 强调了。OK, 强调了 highlighted, right? Highlights, 强调了 the importance, 重要性 the importance of what? Keeping a regular, right? Regular life schedule. 不够，再要加细节。这个还有点细节，同学们，什么是，就是我想问大家，什么是你们所谓的 regular life schedule? 规律的作息时间，应该具体的而言是什么？ Be more specific, 具体而言，什么是规律的作息？什么是规律的作息？To be more specific,具体而言，不要在晚上十一点之前，对吧？拖拖拉拉不睡觉，在听吗？不要拖拉到十一点以后才睡觉，因为这篇文章从非常专业的角度告诉我们，对吧？这个十一点之后进入什么？进入大脑神经的修复期，在听吗？没人理我。你们看软文，听过王老师刚才说这段文字啊，还是我瞎编的呀？具体而言，本文建议我们读者们干嘛？永远不要拖拉，一直到了十一点以后才睡觉。怎么说 ？To be more specific, this article just suggests readers never go to bed, okay, after 11 p.m. 在听吗？This article 文章推荐建议哈 suggests readers.Suggest us, okay? 干嘛？永远不要 never go to bed, right? Go to sleep after what? After 11 p.m. Because 为啥？为啥不要十一点以后睡觉？
对身体不好。
啊，哪儿不好？对指甲不好是吧？对指甲不好，对牙齿不好。
那个内分泌紊乱。
啊，内分泌紊乱，那是因为黄金睡眠期会出现在十一点以后， 如果长此以往会导致内分泌失调，对不对？
嗯。
That's because the golden, right? 黄金嘛 ，the golden or the prime 优选的是吗？优选 prime sleeping time, right? Sleeping time should starts, okay? 开始于什么 ？Starts at 11 p.m. 听吗？黄金睡眠期。OK， 起始于11点钟。下一句呢？反之呢？如果某人怎么了？如果某人长期的去什么那个晚睡觉熬夜的话，内分泌失调起痘痘，是不是？咋说呀？If someone 长期的去晚睡觉怎么说 ？If someone
regular
总是 always stays up late
就直接说熬夜呗、
right? 熬夜怎么说来着开夜车熬夜叫 stay up late 对吧 always stays up late、嗯、stays up late 熬夜 stay up late 嗯哼他的内分泌会失调怎么说
内分泌
he's or her
太专业了
Metabolism, 内分泌吗？嗯哼 ，metabolism, metabolism 是 ME 吧 ？metabolism, 内分泌。就会怎么样 ？Will become 会变得失调 ，disordered， 没有顺序，没有规律的 ，disordered。太专业了，没办法，今天投6.5分的口语，真的需要专业，因为7分就已经被视作是移民分数了嘛。你们家里面有哥哥姐姐移民澳洲的？澳洲移民的分数是8877，总分7.5。向移民局提交一个阅读8分、听力8分、写作7、口语7就可以移民了。移完民之后，正好我有个别的班同学的姐姐，去年刚刚完成这趟活儿，在澳洲读的本科加硕士，然后又考了一段时间雅思之后，终于把雅思成绩考下来了。OK， 普天同庆，喜大普奔。然后那个你特别逗，说那个。分出了以后，提交移民局之后，3天之内就下了身份了，你知道吗？就永居了，你知道吗 ？PR 就下来了，就绿卡拿到了。然后更有趣的是，6天之后就给他派工作了，你知道吗？作为一个澳大利亚的新公民，政府应该给他解决工作机会嘛，就给他下了，就给他找了份工作，去社区，就是有点像居委会，你知道吗？去社区服务站工作，反正也是公务员嘛。然后。他特别害怕，说那我的英语没法跟我们当地的居民沟通啊。他说你不是有 language score 语言分数吗？你都8877了，说明你英语够好了呀。他说我都是用技巧考出来的。所以我刚才说6.5分是高，已经是高分，明明就差0.5分就够移民的分数了。好，第一三段讲的是什么？这篇文章的第一部分讲的是，什么？强调了一下这个。保持规律作息的这个重要性。具体而言呢，文章就是建议读者们干嘛？永远不要去熬夜，对吧？永远不要11点以后睡觉，那是因为11点钟是一个黄金睡眠期的起始期。如果某人经常熬夜的话，我估计这个人会什么呀？他的什么？他的这个什么？这个 metabolism 叫什么来着 ？metabolism。叫这个内分泌是吗？内分泌就会变得非常失常 ，OK， 就变成 disordered。当然了，对于女孩来讲 ，of course。 主要讲这一块主要讲的是这篇文章的内容之一。同时呢 ，secondly， 其次呢，这文章还干嘛了？这篇网络文章还干嘛了？说要让我们多做锻炼，是吧 ？Secondly, this article, right? This article， 怎么了？强调，或者是
emphasizes。
我想再用那个什么，再用那个。Emphasizes 强调了the significance, right? 重要性吧 significance of doing exercise, right? of exercising 锻炼的重要性。比方说刚才我这段文章说什么那是因为随着科技的发展 with the rapid development of science and technology, the number of fathers and homebodies increase a lot. Okay? Apparently, 明显的是这种久坐不站的生活方式 that the dangers or the hazards of this kind of sedentary lifestyle,are quite threatening. 文章里强调的是说的是随着科技的发展是吧，低头族手机客和宅男宅女的数量在不断上升，很明显这种久坐的生活方式对我们健康不好，所以说 so people, right? People are suggested to what? To drop their phones and walk out of their house to do more physical exercises like running. 到这儿吧，对的文字直接搬过来不就完了吗？如果你把它消化掉的话，这个文字很成熟，很严肃，搬进你的演讲当中来，就省得你说的每一句话都是自己现操作的了。All right， 好的，我想我的讲座可以结束了，我给大家两分钟时间。你们任选一个话题，你们可以要么可以选择这个城市的改变，要么可以选择一个你读过的网络软文，可以准备两分钟时间，待会儿要听一个你们的伴读的演讲，因为没有范文，基本上没有范文。开始吧。
老师，那个左边那个文章可以往下一点。
是这样吗？
啊，对。
嗯哼嗯哼。
挡住了。
Huh, Sia, what is the topic? The first one or the second one?
The second one.
Okay, yeah. Please talk about an article that you read from the internet, which is about healthy lifestyle. And you should say when and where you read it, and what the article was about, and how you feel about it. You can start.
Article in the Weibo, which talk about how to keep a healthy life, and this article suggests us to early to bed in the evening and early to raise in the morning to keep a regular life schedule. And it also suggests us to do more exercise and have a healthy diet in the daily life, and more care about our how we spend our life expenses.
Expectancy, uh-huh. 啊，结束了。
嗯。
啊。
啊，嗯，the architecture suggests the readers never.
Article 文章不是 architecture article.
Article suggests readers. Never go to sleep after 11 p.m. because the golden sleep time started at 11 p.m. If someone always stay up very late, his or hers
metabolism
will become disordered. Of course, it's also bad for your skin quality. And secondly, the article emphasized the significance of exercise.
Oh, 哪儿重要的呀？他怎么强调健康的重要性吗？不是，文章针对。Exercising 锻炼有什么样的细节说法呀？这儿还应该有，这儿有些东西，在这儿吧。这文章说，随着科技的发展，对吧？低头族的数量开始变多了，对吗
？And the article said, because the significant in development, there's many
fibers
and home bodies increase a lot, and apparently the dangers of the kind of sedentary lifestyle are quite frightening, so people of today are suggested to drop their phone down and walk out of their house to do more exercise like running, which...
Okay, thank you. 没有了，没有 which is, 再拉长的话就没时间说了。那你对这文章感受如何？ How do you feel about this article that you received from Weibo?
I think it's a good advice for our daily life to keep to keep healthy, and if I do these things, I think my life will be more healthier.
Okay, it will be much healthier. All right, thank you. 方泽， What is the topic? The first one or the second one? A change or a article? You pick one.
Change. 就讲第一个吗？还是第二个？还是我自己选
？You can pick one. The first one or the second one. You can pick one. It's up to you.
I want to talk about the second one.
Okay. No problem. No problem. You can start.To talk about an article that you read from the internet about healthy lifestyle.
Okay. For this topic, I want to share a article I read yesterday, which mainly talk about how to keep a healthy lifestyle. This article give us three main points to keep. Healthy lifestyle. The first one is to keep a regular life schedule. Like, you need to go bed before 11 p.m. because the golden time of sleeping starts at 11 p.m. If someone always stay up late, his or her hormones will become disordered. Of course, it also bad for your skin quality. And the second point is to have a healthy diet. For example, many people have too much beverages in their daily life, like Coca-Cola.Or something like that. This beverage contains much more sugars than people's body needed, which will do harm to your body. This article like suggested us we can drink more waters or juice
water.
Than mm-hmm. water.And the juice than beverages in our daily life. And the third point is to do more exercise. With the development of technology, the number of farmers and homebodies increased a lot. Apparently, the danger of this kind of sedentary lifestyle are quite frightening. So people today are suggested to drop their phones and walk out to their house to do more physical exercise. And that's all.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. 超难哈，超难的不好说，这两篇文章不好说。所以大家下课的时候要把它给写成一个文字稿。OK, 在文字稿的情况下再进行一个英文的讲练，在听吗？因为这是难题，我不说了嘛，它已经跟口语没大关系了，你知道吗？主要是没有思路嘛，对吧？没有信息，没有细节嘛，所以你们可以写一写啊，尝试的啊，写写演讲稿嘛，演讲稿。如果公共演讲是一件轻松的事情的话，就不会演讲家丘吉尔先生存在了，对不对？他们都是非常擅长演讲的人，但一开始他们都写稿子嘛，对吧？稿子说多了以后，词儿多了，对吧？然后再跟人家侃侃而谈，会更自信一点。All right, so we have to move on to number 17. 我给它起名叫家乡特产。这个第一道题叫 Describe a gift you give to someone which took you a long time to choose. 啥意思？问的啥呀？ A gift you give to someone which took you a long time to choose. To prepare. 请你描述一份礼物。这个礼物花了你很长时间去准备，去挑选。很难选的一份礼物。The second one, describe a product such as food or handicrafts, which is made in the region where you come from. 请描述一个什么来自于你的当地、你的家乡的一种食物，不是一种产品，比方说食品或者是手工艺品。我们先看第二个话题 ，which made in the region where you come from， 在你的出处，在你来的那个城市， OK， 很有名的一个 product。那你们知道你们的城市有什么比较有名的 local product 吗？产品吗？北京烤鸭。
稻香村。
稻香村糕点点心铺。嗯哼嗯哼，挺好的，挺好的。那上一个呢？你花了很长时间给别人挑选的礼物，准备的礼物。Describe a gift you give to someone which took you a long time to prepare or to choose。花了很长时间准备为别人准备的礼物。有必要合并吗？有必要合并吗？啊，我是合并了，但是我是合并，因为北京不产茶，所以我特别胆小，肝颤。要不要在北京籍同学面前展现这个 tea 的文章 ？OK。但是如果是什么山西人呢、啊，或者河南人呢、啊、，OK， 或者是南方同学的话，就爆爽了，因为他那边真的是产茶地嘛，福建，对吧？大红袍，云南，啊，普洱，没事。
旅游带回来的东西。
对，如果是茶叶的话，就能不就第一道题是没有任何问题的，就第二个稍微讨厌一点。因为考官都知道北京是不产茶的，或者是不北京也不是山没有山区，所以说你的谎言可能会容易被识破，你知道吗 ？Describe a product such as food or handicraft which is made in the region where you come from。我先把我的范儿读一遍吧，我来读哈，快速的啊。除了若干位北京籍同学来讲的话，用不上我的文章，我给其他同学应该可以用上。比方说方泽就超爽。王老师，我们那云南真的产普洱茶，哎，我说的没错吧？
没错，没错。
OK, great. I'm going to talk about a type of agricultural product, 农产品 agricultural product, which enjoys a nationwide reputation, 享誉全国，享誉全国 enjoys a nationwide reputation. It is green tea.Which is grown or cultivated in the mountainous area of my hometown, 山区位置 in the mountainous area of my hometown. Tea is not only popular with our local people, who usually buy this kind of product and send it as a gift to their family or friends. It is also welcomed by tourists from other cities.They usually buy a few boxes of tea and bring them back to their cities. In my hometown, there is an ancient culture street. There is an ancient culture street named Ma Lian Dao, with many classical styled buildings on both sides. This street is the right place for people to buy the most authentic green tea. In each tea shop,You can find a tea table which displays the green tea with different scents. Tea is a big part of Chinese traditional culture. Therefore, a lot of Chinese people like to drink tea and talk about tea culture. Traditionally, Chinese tea has many special functions in managing people's health condition. For example, drinking tea is good for our digesting system and uplifting our spirit.就是地方特产，我讲的是茶叶。其他同学想说点什么吗 ？A product which is made in the region where you come from, and describe a gift you give to someone which took you a long time to choose or to prepare。你先看第一个吧。已经没法合并了，目前为止。我们还剩三个话题啊，不是没有没剩了，一二三 ，OK， 这三四个话题我已经不想再合并了啊，就是一篇是一篇吧，一篇是一篇吧。首先是 describe a gift， 花了很长时间准备 ，and you should say， 你要告诉我的是 ，you should say， what gift it was， 是什么礼物？It was whom 你送给谁的 ？Whom you sent it? You prepared? Whom you sent it to? 把它送给谁了 ？How long It took you to prepare this gift. How the person felt about your gift. 那个人对你给的礼物感受又如何？有这样的人生经历吗？你煞费苦心，精挑细选，用心良苦，为别人准备一份礼物的过程有吗？应该有吧，绝对有吧。那就把你的这段人生经历讲给我听呗。好，我再把下道题给你敲一小小字儿啊，叫 Describe a product， 你们当地特产。Describe a product in your local area。And you should say, 你要告诉我的是 what product it was. 你要告诉我的是，这是不是这是一个什么样的产品 ？What product it is? 是什么？Who usually 谁一般买这个产品 ？Who usually buy this product? 下一个问的是 where it can be what it can be.Can be found, can be bought. 能够在哪儿被买到这个产品？最后一问是 why it is popular. 在你们当地为什么非常火爆？ Why it is a popular product? It is a popular product. 我来采访一圈。玉伟。你有过给别人挑选礼物大费周折的人生经历吗？
有啊。
那你给我讲讲你的故事呗，中文就可以了。
中文，就是给一个朋友，然后挑一个那个生日礼物嘛，然后就是也不知道。开始不知道挑啥，然后不知道他喜欢啥，然后就然后就反正自己 DIY 了一个啥东西，然后这样的，就是感觉比那些买的会更有一些意义吧，就是
你编了一个什么
啊？
你最后送的什么礼物啊？
他 DIY 的一个东西。
啊 ，DIY 是吧 ？DIY
对，我自己拼了一个乐高的一个东西，就是买
了然后。Good，cool， 大方向是 OK 的啊，大方向超级 OK 的。哎 ，Lego， 挺酷的啊，挺酷的。挺好的，这故事听起来我就想写，为他写一写。诗雅，你呢？有过这样的人生经历吗？
也是，
煞费苦心给别人准备礼物。
纠结生日礼物送人家。
我听不到，自己生什么什么？
就是纠结生日礼物送人家什么东西。
啊，那你送了什么呀？
可以说那个，比如说送，就比如自己花了很多时间，花了很多精力，然后定制一份旅游计划，然后送他去，然后我们一起去旅游，可以吗？
不可以，那不是礼物。
这个不算。
不算。那怎么会是礼物呢 ？Gift 是实际物体啊。东西玩意儿 gift 是个礼物，礼物就是应该是一个实操物品。所以刚才玉伟说的是用乐高小积木块搭建了一个礼物，搭建了一个生日礼物送给自己的舍友大学同学，这是 OK 的呀，毕竟这是实物嘛，对吧，实际物体嘛， object 嘛。所以是啊，你没有告诉我是什么呀，你只是闪烁其词跟我说了一下，好像你会说，但是我又不知道你要说什么。
就是一个比较有趣的，就是一个留声机，然后放上奥利奥，它就会唱歌那种。
啊哈啊哈啊哈啊哈，嗯，不错不错。那为什么花了很长时间准备啊？
因为就是在纠结送什么，就是想了很多东西，然后最后决定了是这个。
嗯哼嗯哼嗯哼，那个人感受如何啊？收到你的留声机之后？
嗯，觉得很有趣。
然后他就把奥利奥饼干吃掉了，是吧？
对。
买了很多奥利奥饼干，然后两半年以后见了那个姑娘以后，那姑娘已经比你胖了一圈了，对吧？然后其实这是你的心机，是不是？你想的是，你丫不是比我瘦吗？你丫不是比我瘦吗？不是比我，是吧？就是你就是你玩的一个宫斗剧，你知道吗？宫斗剧，给他养肥了。行，就这样吧。好，作业啊。自我创作，同学们，这篇章自我创作一下，因为今天我要收官了啊，今天我要收官 part two 了 ，OK， 自我创作一下，然后把那个稿子给我看，或者把录音文本给我听也都成。下一个是你们当地特产，说什么好？我继续采访。博雅，您北京有什么特产啊？你有欲望去说的。
稻香村的点心啊，
随便啊，你对他感，你对这玩意儿有点心不错啊，京八件是吧？京八件啊哈，京八件啊哈，绿豆糕，绿豆黄是吧？是吧？这绿豆黄，豌豆黄，
豌豆黄，
豌豆黄，行啊，可以啊，没问题啊 ，OK， 酷酷的。那我问问小魏同学呢，你们家乡特产有什么特产啊？
河北的特产可能驴肉火烧吧，我只知道这个。
不是，我没有让你去介绍，怎么讲，为河北代言，我只是说你今天为了这个话题准备说哪个东西，你要定位好，你完全可以没必要为了你的河北代言，你知道吗？那就是你们当地盛产的一种当地产品，比方说食品或者手工艺品，你都可以说呀。
山东 province 那个竹编。
竹编，很棒，这个一定是一个精彩的竹编工艺品，对不对？对吗？
Yeah.
一定会是一个精彩的故事。你说老师我不会，我也不会啊。Bamboo， 什么呀 ？Bamboo craft，I don't know。所以你要去调研一下 ，OK？ 看看一些网站对于竹编的一些描述，好不好
？OK。
好的，我们看这道题啊，叫描述一次你把什么东西 ，occasion when you lost something and you got it back。啊，这道题已经不考了。这道题已经不考了，但再考的会是这个。Describe a time when a person apologized to you， 请你描述一次别人向你道歉的一次经历。A person apologized to you， 描述一次别人向你道歉的经历。你要说什么时候发生的，谁给你道歉了，为什么这个人向你道歉，你的感受如何？那孟竹，我说说你的故事呗。有人给你道歉吗？我妈妈给我道歉了，因为她不给我买好吃的。
一个故事，突然说也想不起来，道歉的故事。
某个人做了一件事情，伤害到了你，影响到了你，然后他也意识到了，然后主动向你道歉，有吗？
想不出来现在。
嗯哼。
道歉。
那你今天送歉呢？
可以说那个误机吗？比如说由于朋友迟到，然后所以我们误机，他向我道歉。
OK 的，不叫误机，应该是他自己磨磨蹭蹭吧。
啊，对。
他家住大兴，然后去北京首都机场，他自己没拿捏好时间，对不对？他没拿捏好时间，对吗？ 或者自己磨叽了，没拿捏。拿捏好时间，也许干嘛了？路上磨叽了是吧？对不对？
对。
然后呢？怎么了？但那个他迟到了，他迟到了。于是乎，你们两个怎么都错过航班是吗？错过了去上海的航班是吗？
啊，对，错过了航班，
只能改去香港的航班，爱去哪去哪，去香港的航班。然后他各种跟你各种怎么样？各种道歉，对不对？各种道歉，还答应干嘛？答应你去香港帮你升级什么？升级酒店房间。答应请你什么？请你去看什么？请你去看香港红磡对吧？的一曲演唱会可以吗？
嗯。
香港歌手 ，OK， 演唱会作为赔偿，对不对？歉意的赔偿。这编呗，那咋办呀？啊，你这不是编，这是真事是吧？
嗯，不是，因为咱们之前讲过一个飞机晚点，然后就想起来。
嗯，挺好的，挺好的，挺好的，这故事可以编啊。反正就是编的，嗯哼，我可没有碰到这么不靠谱的朋友啊，把航班都给我耽误了，我可没碰到过。行吧，这也是一份作业啊，这也是一份作业。大家在这个课程结束之前呢，还是努力的把这几故事都写一写 ，OK， 然后呢，把那个稿件或者是音或者是把你的文字稿或者是你的语音版。OK， 发给老师给你审一下，在听吗？听到了吗？这样的话，我们就能够什么呀？这个讲义结束了，就能够把现有题库当中所有的话题都过了一遍，都配上了相应应该有的文章。OK， 这是雅思备战的一条必经之路啊，对吧？配文，然后呢，那个拿着这篇靠谱的文章进行反复的说练。OK， 考试当天如果碰到原题再现 ，OK。快速冲上6分6.5分的概率会大得多得多，在听吗？
嗯
嗯哼，明白，对吧？当然了，你开始接触雅思的过程，也就是你英语变强大的过程中，你接触雅思的过程就是你英语变得好起来的过程。OK， 比如说听力耳朵变精了，对吧？然后阅读开始一目十行了，对不对？写作开始有点结构感了，开头段开始更给力了。口语呢，编故事能力更强了，对不对？然后单词发音错误率降低了，这都是学习雅思过程当中对你英语的一个总体的一个贡献，好吧？这是作业答案明朗了吗 ？OK， 明朗了吗？要写几个单独的故事哈，四个吧。一，哎，哪去了？道歉的经历是第一个，然后是当地特产第二个，然后是精心挑选的礼物是第三个故事。还有一个是家乡的改变，你们家乡的一个 change 哪去了？在这儿呢，四个吧。即使在这个课程结束之前，大家要完成掉，好吧？好嘞，你们下课了，带好别的课，不耽误你们了，拜拜。
嗯。